need to be touched and impacted. See, I want you to know many people today are turning away from God.
All right.
And many people tired of church, you know. They make excuses not to be in church. But you, the faithful that are standing and employed in the work of God, you know, you are setting yourself for a greater reward. Because he is a rewarder. And you've been called into the kingdom for what? Such a time as this. Amen. God knew what he was doing when he called you into the kingdom. Amen. In this season, in this hour. And the Spirit is said to tell you, to let you know that you are special.
Amen.
And there is a greater grace about to fall on you for this church. A greater spirit of enlargement, said the Spirit. Yeah. God is going to begin to fill more chairs there. I don't know if you probably ain't got enough room now.
Praise the Lord.
But amen. God says he's going to begin to fill more chairs to get people to come to church like they should, you know.
Amen.
Because, you know, people make excuses and put other things before God.
All right.
You don't hear me what I'm saying. But God is about to really set the presidents in their life to like put a fireband on their tail. That they get up in the church where they're supposed to be and where they belong.
Amen.
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 See, I know everybody gets tired and the scripture says, let us not be weary in well-doing. For in due season you shall reap if you faint not.
Amen.
See, you got a due season. Because the Almighty, that is not a man that should lie, have confessed that to you. So you got a due day coming. You got a time that God has set up to show up in your life to specialize in a specific blessing for you. You see, it ain't for nobody else, it's for you. It's something God that has been waiting on and working on to do exclusively for you. And so you ought to celebrate God just because of that. That he has a special blessing. That he has a special touch. That he's getting ready to do. You know, I see the Lord touching some of you. And that you ain't gonna never be the same. I heard the man of God say that. But the Spirit just told me and quickened me to tell you, you ain't gonna never be the same. After this night, this hour. My God. And you see, I don't try to be no prosperity preacher, but that's just a part of the whole counsel of God. It's part of the whole counsel, you know. And I hear the Lord speaking in that manner about prospering his people even the more. And we need all the prosperity we can get for what we're called to do. You know, today and me moving through the day, I hadn't felt this way in a long time, you know, because I know the opposition that I was facing. And I said, God must really be up to something tonight to touch somebody's life, because the enemy wouldn't be fighting against me for nothing. You see, that's evidence when the enemy is fighting against you. God is about to do something. My God. So we receive it, Lord. Amen. I want you to turn with me to the foundational text of Isaiah 48. Glory to God. I praise you, Lord. Could you stand up, ma'am? You. No. Listen, I never saw you in my life, but you know, God just quickened me to tell you that he's getting ready to increase you more financially. You know, your face just came in my spirit, and he told me to tell you that. That he's getting ready to do it for you in this hour. You've been trusting and you've been waiting on him. You've been prevailing over some storms and some issues. But God said, I'm getting ready to do it for you in this hour, saith the Spirit of the living God. You've been waiting on the Lord, and he's going to entrust you. Amen. Glory. Isaiah 40. Starting at verse 17, Jesus is Lord, amen. I yield unto you, Holy Spirit, that you reveal your mind to your people, amen. Excuse me, First Lady, but while I was sitting down, the Lord told me to tell you that he's getting ready to put a reward in your hand. He's going to reward you with some stuff. See, you're already a blessed woman of God. But God is getting ready to do something special even the more to distinguish you even the more in your finances. And even in your soul, God says, there's about to be a stirring of the Spirit where God is visiting you to take you to another height. Another height.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God.
Because of the level of prosperity that you're getting ready to walk in. Greater grace is upon you. I hear the Lord saying, success, success. You know, when that's a covenant, isn't it? When God says something twice, that's success, success. I mean, that's a covenant statement. He said to Abraham, Abraham, amen. He said to Joshua, you know what I'm saying? So when God speaks, you know, in multiples like that, he's confirming himself. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes, God. Isaiah 48 and verse 17. The scripture declares, amen. Thus saith the Lord, thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I am the Lord thy God, which teacheth thee to profit. The B clause says, which leadeth thee by the way that thou shouldest go. Yeah. Oh, that thou hadst hearken to my commandment, then had thy peace been as a river and thy righteousness as the wave of the sea. You see, the Lord is speaking in this Old Testament text here to the children of Israel, but not only was he speaking to the children of Israel, he was speaking perpetually to the people of God, period. And we glean from the truth that he's declaring to them in this present day to realize that God is declaring to us the very same, because he is not a man that he should lie. Amen. Even though Israel were the call to reveal God to the nations and to be a nation of kings and priests, but they are no better than you, I want you to know.
Right.
You're just as valuable, just as precious, just as honorable to the Lord as they were. And his word is given to the whole house of God. And he said, thus saith the Lord, thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, I am the Lord thy God, which teacheth thee to prosper, or teacheth thee to profit. And God has a specific direction for each and every one of you. Yes, many of you, you know, you get jobs and you get employment and you get degrees and you take career choices, but I want you to know that God has an express way that he would have you to go, where he wants you to seek him exclusively about how to profit in your life. See, we have jobs for comfort and to help us manage, but our jobs just is a source to give us the seed, a seed to plant, in confirmation of the prophetic word that God speaks into your life. And you see, I know your man of God you sit on has an apostolic, a prophetic anointing. And God uses him to convey to you direction for you to go in, amen? But see, God wants you to be more sensitive to the Spirit of the Lord as he uses him to convey to you his thoughts. God is giving his thoughts towards you. But specifically, God wants you to know it is he that teaches thee to profit. The knowledge and the information that you got is not by chance. But God is specifically causing to channel to you specific information to prosper you in a specific arena in this hour. And you got to be open to receive him as the way that he's instructing you. You see, today so many things are happening in society. So many things that CNN is purporting and Fox is purporting. And we listen to things and we absorb things. And a lot of times we allow things to rattle us that we get off track from what God is specifically doing in our life. And see, what God is saying to me, to you, to tell you tonight, that you got to stay more on track with him teaching you to prophet. You got to stay more on track. There are many, over the years, I prophesied to many people. And, you know, people said, well, people just come into church to use you. And that may be so, and I'm functioning in an office that's the ointment on my life. But even as I conveyed, I'm being obedient to God now to get to the people the information. I've seen many people reach levels and obtain things, but I've seen people purposely avoid to implement things that I've said. You know, there was a member that called me the other day, you know, that God gave her a word about her having a bank over her head and for her to open up this specific type of business. And she never did open it up. She didn't follow the course that God said specifically for her to get her wealth. She pursued another way. She said she had a lawsuit and she was believing God and she really wanted me to pray for her, but I didn't pray for her because she didn't obey the voice of the Lord. You see, when I conveyed her the word and gave it to her, and she knew that I ain't going to keep wasting my time. Because we are people that live by faith. We walk specifically with what God is saying. And I know that when she followed it, she would have got what God said. And so we have to be sensitive specifically to what God is saying in our life. I know you to be a great house of faith and you hear the man of God and you speak. I mean, you receive what he's saying. But God wants you to be more sensitive to it in this hour, my God. Because I hear the Lord say, I'm getting ready to enlarge and expand. I'm causing you to grow up for the faith and grow up for the ministry even the more. And I'm quickening you in this hour that you can be more satisfied. Oh, yes, God want to bring satisfaction. Yeah, he want to please you. He want to reward you. And I know you have rewards that you have received and things, but God want to quicken you to enlarge you even the more. Tell your neighbor, God wants to bless you. The scripture is not giving us information where he said we would be the head and not the tail. God wants you to be on top in every situation. He don't want you to be the bottom. He don't want you to be, God wants you to be on the top in every situation. But you got to follow the information. You got to use discipline in your life, discipline in your walk. But God wants you to be able to handle your situation. Whatever it may be that surfaced before you, God wants you to be on top. Because he's God Almighty. Why would he be God Almighty and have his children in a position where they don't know how they're going to make it or? And so we got to sit back and look and make the adjustment in our life. But we got to walk disciplinedly. Amen. Listen, he said, the way we should go that will prosper you or advance you. Or produce a successful journey in God's vision. That's why he's going to teach you how to prosper. Because he has a purpose for your life. That purpose needs to be fulfilled because it is the word of God. He said, my word will not return unto me void, but it will accomplish the very thing that I have sent it for to do. To what? Prosper. Prosper means to cause you to be successful. Prosper means that you would advance. You see, and I know, you know, the title of this conference is that prospering in God, amen? Profiting in God. And you know, prospering in God, that word ophelia, primarily, which comes from the Greek, which we interpreted from, means assistance, advancement, and benefits. God is going to give you assistance. You don't hear me. Benefits and advantages in your life. When circumstances rise and you show up and they see that you got advantage over me, don't be mistaken. That is the favor. That is God's desire. That is a window that God opened up in a Kairos moment for you. And you got to be knowledgeable and step into it and walk in what good. Don't be looking back at other people. But you got to get what God specifically is channeling to you. Yeah, we are a many-member body. But individually in our walk, we got to receive in our season how God wants to bless us individually. You can't be blessed at the level that God wants you to when you're worried about what's around you and who ain't got. You got to be fearful that you may miss what God, because when it comes, it's coming in a Kairos moment. That's a special time, a special season. You can miss that season. You can miss it by foolishness, by not moving in the hour that God said, my God. And so, is the Lord that teacheth thee to profit? The Lord began to channel to me in the way that the Lord used me. You know, before I was a pastor, I had a successful business, making money galore, driving the Benz, and you know, people was assessing that he must be a drug dealer. You know, I had rims on the car, and they said, well, you know, you're pretty, you're not supposed to have rims, but, you know, we're supposed to walk in the best. You know, I see everybody got them now, but the people, you know, but I walked in the favor to obtain my desires. And I just didn't get that by chance because, you know, I had went out on a lot, laid hands on a car and prayed. And God opened up the door to show me how to get that specific car. Yeah, yeah. He spoke to me to tell me what to do to get what I wanted. You see, he's teaching you and I how to prosper specifically. But we got to have a life centered now in connection and prayer with him. When you pray to him, the scripture says that when you pray to him in secret, he will reward you. He wants to reward you to give you what you want. But you got to be serious and focused on my God. Because he said, I want to teach you to profit. I want to teach you to profit in this hour. You know, God wants other people to see church folks in the rightful place. Because many times people got the wrong attitude about us. They got the wrong attitude about us. They see us the wrong way. When God wants them to see you how you really are, a people that are walking in a very successful place, whose children are coming into alignment to receive the blessings off of your life. You know, because the scripture is going to line up, you know, it's going to line up that you could be a blessing to your children and their. Well, you see, God is busy performing his word and doing this, but he wants you to be in cooperation with him as he align it. It's bigger than you. It's bigger than you. You got to yield in your generation where you are to work that God can facilitate to you that you can be a blessing to the next generation. Yeah. And even their children. Amen. You see, you know, God is dealing with us generationally. Mm-hmm. Just like he dealt with Abraham, Isaac, and three generationally. God wants to bless you in your generation, yeah. That you can bless your children. And he's the same God. Amen. We got the same blessing of Abraham upon us. Yes. He wants to work it out the same way, but he wants you to be knowledgeable about it and disciplined in your life. Because a lot of times he may pour money into your life and you may think, this is for my new car. But God wants you to put that money up. He wants you to sow, yeah, But he wants you to put that money or put it away. Because in your child's life that's coming up, they're going to need you to be in position to pour into their life. To help them get in some doors. You see, God is teaching you how to profit. And when you're teaching your children of their form, then they're able to obtain what you are pouring out, verbally and physically. Then they can be the one that extend it to the next generation. Because you've operated, my God, you've operated in the knowledge that God is conveying unto you that you will walk in a greater level. You see, it's time for us to be very more knowledgeable people of God. We got to be. For our sake. You know, the way that we should go, that will prosper us. Prosper means to cause you to be successful. It means to cause you to succeed. That word is really interchangeable with the word profiting, where God spoke about in the Old Testament. Because they generally mean the same thing.
Yeah.
But God wants you to use what he's pouring into your life to advance you.
Yeah.
It's bigger than clothing, you know. Yeah. A lot of times we get stuff and we want to run it. You got to learn that everything ain't for your wardrobe. Yeah, you can have some pieces, you know, and some shoes, but it ain't for all of it, ain't for your wardrobe.
Amen.
You got to put something away for another day.
Amen.
God wants you to be smart.
Amen.
Because he's teaching you how to profit. Even as you implement this, God is not saying he's not going to keep pouring into your life. But he's just blessing you in the streams that he's causing to flow into your life, that you have multiple incomes coming in.
Come on, man.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord.
You have multiple incomes, I said.
Yeah.
Some may be bigger than others, but it's coming.
Yeah.
It's coming. And you got to realize and see it when it's coming and put it in the right place. You know, we have to realize that when God began, or when he began to speak through the prophet Isaiah to the people, that it is he that teacheth his people to profit. He had generationally done it in other believers' life. And you know, some people will say, well, God liked them more than they liked me. That's not true. God loves us all the same. All of us have a connection with God. All of us don't have the same purpose specifically, but he loves us all the same. And he wants all of us to do well, to flourish, to advance. In our communities, you know, he's calling us to really be a city that is set up on a hill. A city is multiple people. It's not one or two people. But it's a community of people. He wants all of us. My God. Listen, let's move. I want you to go to 2 Chronicles very quickly. 2 Chronicles 26. Let's start at verse 1. The scripture says, then all the people of Judah, 2 Chronicles 26 and verse 1. Then all the people of Judah, all the people of praise, took Uzziah, who was 16 years old, and made him king in the room of his father Amaziah. He built Eloth and restored it to Judah. After that, the king slept with his fathers, and 16 years old was Uzziah when he began to reign, and he reigned 52 years in Jerusalem. His mother's name also was Jecoliah of Jerusalem, and he did that which was right in the sight of the Lord. It didn't say he did what's wrong. It said he did which was right. He did that which was right in the sight of the Lord, according to all that his father Amaziah did. And he sought God in the days of Zechariah, or Zechariah the prophet, who had understandings in the vision of God. And as long as he sought the Lord, as long as he sought the Lord, God made him to what? As long as he put God first, as long as he implemented that word that came out of the prophet, he prospered. He advanced. He exceeded. He was increased as long as he sought the Lord. You got to be seeking the Lord for information and revelation. When you get that word from your bishop, your apostle, your prophet, you ain't hear me what I'm saying. You got to seek the Lord on specifics on how to implement it. You're responsible. Many times people sit back and wait on the preacher to do it. The preacher's job is to preach to you, to brief you in the services, but you got to walk it out. You ain't hear me what I'm saying. You got to walk it out. You got to implement it. That you can be more profitable in your life. Because God wants you to go into different avenues of society. It's stuff out there with your name on it. It's stuff out there that's assigned to you. But you got to go out there and get it. You can't be walking in fear. You can't be walking in timidity. But you got to be bold to obtain it. Because God wants you to be able to look out for your church. He wants you to be able to look. How are you going to look out for your church if you ain't got nothing? How are you going to look at, how are you going to work in your church and push your church forward and you ain't got nothing to push it with? See, when you come in, you may be in a needy situation and God may build you up and he may prosper you and bring you to a place of stability. But God wants you to get the mind now. It's time for me to pour into the church and to push it that we can touch other people. That we can extend the purpose of God. And I promise you, as you do that, you will grow exceedingly. You'll be able to touch your children's lives. You'll be able to affect them more powerfully because you're moving in the purpose. The same purpose. But we are co-laborers with Jesus Christ. The same purpose is to fulfill that very goal that the Lord has to reconcile all men. You got some people that you got to touch. You got some people that you got to influence. He sought the prophet in the things of God. He sought the prophet in the things of God. The things that the prophet conveyed to him, he sought the prophet. But not only did he kept seeking God. And the Bible said he prospered. Or he profited. He profited. You know, that's what scripture said. You believe the Lord, so shall you be established. You believe his and you will. The scripture is confirming itself. It said it in multiple places, but you got to have it. You got to believe it. And you got to believe that it is going to work for you. And it will work for you. God will turn other people around when you got favor, when you got faith. He'll turn other things that other people were scheduled. God will put you in position to get it. Because they don't have the right mind, the right attitude. God will set you up. Because you're managing it right. I'm telling you, God will look over people for you to get you something because you're managing it properly. My God. I said, because you're managing it properly, you got the right attitude. God will look over some people and get it to you because you know what to do with it. You know how to handle it. And that doesn't mean that he's not good because he reigns on the just as well as the unjust. But he wants things to be managed in the earth properly.
Amen.
My God. You know, prospering God's way is not about doing it the world's way.
Amen.
It's not about doing it the world. We're in the world, but we're not of the world. We're in the world, but we don't act like the world. You know, God wants us to have the fancy cars, too, the fancy houses, the nice, but we still don't have the character of the world.
Amen.
We don't have the attitude of the world. We are godly people. We're peculiar people. We're different. But it doesn't say you can't have it.
Amen.
But he, in this greater level that he wants to pour out and perfect you in, he wants you to have the right attitude.
Amen.
My God, I see women in this place getting new clothing and new homes.
Hallelujah.
I'm looking. I see it in the spirit.
Hallelujah.
Of y'all getting homes and clothes and God bartering new things to you. Don't get mad, men. He just showed me the women. I saw women. Are the women outdoing the men in this house? Huh? It's all right because the men, you got to catch up. I know women, you know, they have a tendency to be more hungry for things. But I saw women. But that's another. You know, God's prospering God's way is not doing it the world's way.
Amen.
But it's doing it God's way. And it brings assistance, advantages, and benefits. It brings assistance. It brings advancement and benefits. It brings assistance, advancement, and benefits. In your walk with God, you get assistance in areas. You get advantages. You get benefits. Ain't nobody hearing me. God has specifically given this to you. It is seemingly like a reward that he's channeling to you because of your faithfulness, saith the Spirit. You know, I've been hearing the Lord say to tell them that I'm their source all day. And I know y'all already know that, but God wants you to know it to a specific extent, that he's your source for real. And if he's your source, that means you are scheduled to get things that's coming from God specifically for you. Can't nobody stop you. But you must walk in the understanding to know. And you must be motivated. And I ain't talking about you always being motivated to just get stuff. Because when you are seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, all those will be added. It is coming by way of you walking in faithfulness to God. It's God's desire and it is God's anointing and power that's causing things to. He's touching people, influencing them to be a blessing to you. He wants you to be understanding to know that you're supposed to have it. Enlargement is on this house. It's on you. I'm seeing it. I'm seeing enlargement on you all. It's your time to shine. It's your time to go forward into things of God. God says, even for you, it's your time, it's your season, God says, when he's opening doors and he's teaching you to profit even the more. He's teaching you. Wow. I give you honor, God. I give you honor, God. I see it on you, Sister Regina. You know, I'm seeing this. The Spirit is speaking in. Hallelujah. I'm seeing people that God is really impressing upon me even the more. Even for you, Bishop, God said, it's yours. It's getting ready to come like never before. You get ready to enter a season where things are going to gravitate to you favorably. And you know, like you were sharing me when y'all went fishing in the mid, people really finna start talking about you now. It comes with a price. People really getting ready because of what's on you. Because those that preach the gospel should what? Live up the gospel. Huh? You're supposed to live up, and it's supposed to be. And God said, it's getting ready to come to you in this hour. Y'all believe in God for a new home. God's getting ready to open up doors for y'all. I don't know, but I see like a, I'm looking like at a three level. A three level house. Wow. That God is getting ready to do. Glory. Y'all better bless you, Bishop, for God. God said he wants you to bless him and see him through. He wants you to pour into him. That's what God is telling me to tell you. I hear the voice of God. God said as you sustain him, he's going to sustain you. He's going to help you prosper individually. God didn't give you the man of God for nothing for you to neglect and look over. And God said, even as you submit to me and sow in his life, it's coming to you.
Amen.
Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over what men give unto your bosom. You see, you got to do what God told you to do. And God's going to do what he promised you he would do. No matter how it looks, you got to do what God told you to do. When it looks like the enemy is coming, trying to defy you and work again, you got to continually do what God says for you to do. And God is going to do supernaturally what he promised you he was going to do. Nothing can stop God. Nothing. Nobody. But you got to be on track and on course to do what God said to do, and God is going to implement his word for you. My God. I don't know why I needed to say that. Because somebody here allow the enemy or situation to say, well, I can't do it now. In spite of what happens in your life, do what God said for you to do. For your church, for your house, glory. And he's going to prosper you. Man of God, I see new doors opening for you. He's going to visit you. It's your time. No, I'm looking at 30 years. Something like 30 years you've been in it and laboring. By 20 is around that. Yeah, I'm in the arena, right?
Yes, sir.
But I hear God saying, you know, some things he's getting ready to implement because of your faithfulness. Wow. It's yours, said the Spirit. Hallelujah. In the book of Hebrews, chapter 1. The scripture says, glory, hallelujah. Let us therefore fear lest a promise being left us of entering into his rest. Now we know rest means to be the finished work that God has already done. The scripture said he declares the ending from the what? From the beginning. He's already done it. We got to walk into it by way of faith. That means God and we went and created everything and finished it and then came back to you and your generation and is encouraging you to walk in faith to the duration to perform your purpose. But he's already declared the endings from the beginnings. Now let's go back. It says, let us therefore fear lest a promise being left us of entering into his rest. And any of you should come to, should seem to come short of it, for unto us was the gospel preached, or the good news preached, as well as unto them, but the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. You see, this is a challenge to you because there have many that have received prophetic words where God has spoken about the promise that he wanted to do. And many didn't mix faith with the words that were preached to them, and they didn't receive the promise of what God was saying. I told you, God said you're responsible for your own stuff. Bishop can't do it for you. He can preach it, and but you got to be continually on course to fulfill that purpose. The scripture is not lying to us. It's giving us a witness. Let us therefore fear, lest a promise being left us of entering into his rest, and any of you should seem to come short of it. For unto us was the gospel preached, as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them. It didn't profit them. It was supposed to profit them. It was supposed to advance them. Ain't nobody saying nothing. It was supposed to profit. Not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. You see, we have a witness now for those that received it. And they said, well, I preached a priest and ain't nothing happened in my life. Because they didn't mix faith with the words that were preached to them. Well, what is faith? Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things that are. The scripture says, by faith the elders obtained the what? Good report. So the elders received what was spoken to them because they mixed faith with it. Well, God is challenging you to put faith with yours that you're hearing. Because God got something special for you, and it ain't like everybody. It is your stuff. It's your things. It's your home. It's your marriage. But you got to specifically hear it. You got to specifically walk in. Yes, it's good that we celebrate with our friends and relatives, but specifically you got to be on track for yours. Do you hear me what I'm saying? And not miss it because you're not mixing faith. Faith walks toward what is believing God, what has been spoken. Faith is walking forward to obtain it. It's not I'm waiting on God. No, God is waiting on you. He's done everything. He's sitting on the throne, and what Jesus said is finished. I reappropriate and align you now. Now go and get it. Because faith is the substance. And because it hadn't come to your life in 10 years don't mean it's not going to come. You know, there's things that God prophesied to me 20 years ago. And I'm still walking in belief. Walking to receive it. He's still prophesying to me about it. But I have to stay on track to receive it. I'm still battling the enemy concerning believing it every day. I'm still battling situations that are trying to defy and abort me from obtaining it. But I'm walking forward in God. And as long as I walk, he's going to perform that long-term promise. And how do I know? Because he's performing short-term promises to motivate me to keep me on track to get the long-term. See, that's evidence that you're on the right. He's going to do it because he's rewarding you in short-term blessings. Things that are motivating, encouraging you. He's going to do the long-term promises that he said. You see, you're a believer, not a short-term believer. You're a believer for the rest of your life. He's going to give long life. He's going to satisfy you. And because he doesn't do it in the first quarter of your life, don't be discouraged. Or the second quarter, he still got time. He still can show up. When he show up in the fourth quarter and do it, you still gonna obtain. Remember, he's blessing you to be a blessing to your children and them. So if he's giving it to you when you get older, that means that he's setting your children up. He's giving it to you in the time when you're mature and balanced enough that you understand it's for you to push the next generation. Because you remember, God is dealing with us generationally for our seed to be saved. Remember, he said that when we are saved, that he will save our children. That's the same thing. Am I right? And so God knows what he's doing. You got to appropriate. You got to appropriate your time and your mentality to stay on track with what he's doing. Because we get selfish and we get mad and frustrated and think it's about just about us. But it's bigger than us. It's bigger than us. It's about our children and their children also. Not saying that God doesn't want us to walk in the level, but he's metering out to us. You don't have a bad life now. Amen. Your life is blessed right now. Amen. He's your friend right now. Amen. He see you through right now. Amen. He take care of you right now. Amen. He bless you right now. And so he's doing what he said. He's a good God.
Yes.
But he's a sovereign God, amen? He does it the way he wants to do it, amen? Glory. In 2 Corinthians 9, I want to show you something. You see, the enemy is trying to kill somebody's faith. He's always on a course to destroy your faith. If he can destroy your faith, he can rob you of what God wants to do. Somebody needed to hear that. Because that's what he's on course to do. But you got to stay faithful. Believe God. Believe his word. Stay in the way. You know, Jesus said in this life we'll have tribulation. So you can expect when you see some trouble, you expect the enemy to show. But you know God got the last word.
Yes,
you know God got our back.
Yes,
and he wants you to stand still and know that he's God in spite of what happens. Because he's still going to do it.
Yes,
he's still going to make it happen.
Amen.
My God. Listen, this scripture says, 2 Corinthians 9, and let's start at verse 6. But I say this, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly. And he which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Every man as he purposeth in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. He loveth a cheerful giver. And God is able to make some grace. No, he said, God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that ye always, having all sufficiency in all things that may abound to every good work, as it is written, he hath dispersed abroad, he hath given to the poor, his righteousness remains forever. Now he that ministers seed to the sower, both ministering bread for your food. And multiply your seed sown. And increase the fruit of your. God wants you to be seed minded. Because this is the way that you profit. This is the way that you advance. You don't look at your situation to say you cannot afford to seed. You cannot afford to give. That's why he was telling you being good and holding up your man of God in the house. Because as you give, what did he say? He said he's going to visit you.
Yeah.
You're performing your portion of it. Step back and allow God to be God and perform his promise.
Yeah.
By you doing what you're supposed to do.
Yeah.
And everybody ain't got to know how you bless your man of God.
Amen.
And everybody ain't got to know how you bless him and prosper him.
Amen.
But God knows, amen.
Right.
Because God is going to perform his word. And he took me this way to tell you. Because he wants you to understand your giving is not in vain.
Amen.
Your giving is not something that the preacher make up.
All
Because the same way that you give to your preacher gives to his man of God. He lives by the same standard. He has to do the very same thing. Because none of us are dismissed from walking in this order because God instituted this. You know, there was a time or two, I was mad at my bishop, you know what I'm saying? And I was like, I'm sending him all this money, and you know, I can't get a conversation, we can't hear from him. And God spoke to me, he said, you just do what I told you to do. And I'm going to do what I'm supposed to do for you. Sometimes you get mad because you may not be able to talk to your bishop, your man of God, you know, because he got some things going on that has swallowed him up. But when you perform your responsibility to God, God is overseeing your obedience. He's overseeing. He has angels dispatched. He has things working out on your behalf that are going to come to fruition because you're obeying his way. You see, the man of God is standing in the place that God put him in to be faithful. He's a man. But when you're performing and being obedient to the word, that opens up the door for God to perform his promise in your life. Because he's God. He's the one that's God. God wants you to stay faithful and on track, he said. Because he's really working to set you up on your feet to do some things for you that nobody else can do. And he wants to bring you forward that you could be a real spiritual force to be reckoned with individually. You see, we are the church. We're something else in the earth. Do you hear me what I'm saying? We are something else in the earth. Without us being in the earth, it would be a wreck, a mess. Yes, there are things are going on now, but we're here. And because we're here and doing things, we're making a difference. We're revealing God to this gross darkness. We're revealing God and his way. And so God wants us to stay on track with that. But remember, he said, every man, as he purposeth in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly, not being angry or frustrated, or this, for God loveth a cheerful giver. Because God is able to make all grace abound towards you. When you walk in the store, God can cause grace to abound. When you walk in the water company, when you walk in the light, the place to pay your light or electric, but when you go to the mall, you may see some people come up and just snatch a price off and reduce the price. That was for you. God is causing grace to abound. When you go on the car lot, huh? And you want this specific car, and you know they reduce. This is grace abounding towards you. This is just one of the ways that God is reducing things that you'll be able to get up in it. Even for you that are trying to obtain a house, a home, God is working on your behalf. Amen. He's blessing. Amen. He's going to perform his word. Amen. He said to tell you, I'm going to satisfy you. Amen. Get ready. Amen. Get ready, God said. Amen. That's what you need to be doing, getting ready. Amen. Getting ready to step into it, getting ready. You just continue to stay positive and stay on track, and he's working out. God said he's getting ready to enlarge you. He's getting ready, even in this church. God said he's getting ready to enlarge you. He's getting ready to do some things for you financially. Amen. Amen. To bring a more soundful place. You're already intelligent, you know, but God, when you get more, it causes you to be more comfortable. Amen. It causes you to feel better mentally. You ain't hear me what I'm saying. Well, God said he's getting ready to do that for you. He's going to show up for you. I see your mind being more comfortable. And you've been going through some things that have been literally trying to shake or disturb you. But I see you being more comfortable and happy, more at peace, more satisfied. More stuff is coming. Set the spirit. You just continue to be sweet and kind. He's working it out for you. He's working it out. Amen. But he's able to cause all grace to abound towards you. That you always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. My God. prospering in God's system, being increased in God's system. That's what we're really talking about. You know, I've been in a situation where initially God asked to obtain a church location that was very nice and desirable, and the city came and bought it. And we had another place, and then God opened the door for us to purchase this church, and it was an area that I did not like. It was an area that I wouldn't go in.